What does this game have to do with having a baby?
Absolutely nothing.
All right, Amber, I officially declare you the winner, even though you were nowhere near Johnny's mouth.
Yes.
And you win a giant.
Well, listen to her. She can help you too.
Just so scared. It's gonna hurt. I mean, what if it's
stories. What if I go into labor for days? I don't think I can take it.
Don't worry, we'll be with you.
And you've been doing everything you can to get ready, your exercises and your prenatal yoga with Lisa at that cute little studio the time of day. Jenny, you've been doing everything you can to get ready. And it's normal to be worried, but long labors and unexpected surprises aside, when you finally get to gaze down on that sweet little baby face, you quickly realize that whatever it is you go through to get in here is so worth it in the end.
What's going on? What's wrong?
Oh, little mama-to-be is just a little worried.
About what? You don't think you're going to have one of those labor nightmares like those morons in the other room are talking about, do you? Oh, my goodness. You're going to give birth so quick that if you blink your eyes, you're going to miss it. Wait and see. All the women in our family do. Why, when I had you, the midwife had barely even gotten there, and she lived only a block away. Wham! Bam! Baby! Trust me, it'll be over so quick you'll be disappointed there wasn't more to it.
See, you have nothing to worry about.
I told you, listen to your mother.
Right.
Come on back to the party. There's no sense having a party for you and the baby if neither one of you are there.
Okay, but do I have to wear that stupid hat?
Yes. Yes.
Better get what I get.
Thank you. right? They walked up and they looked at me and they stopped and I didn't move a muscle. And then after you scared them, they came back behind me and I jumped up and screamed. I think they cracked themselves.
The best part of Halloween, the thing that makes it all worthwhile, is when you can make a little kid do that
heebie jeebie dance.
I can't believe I'm sitting here feeling miserable and listening to you two bogos scare innocent little kids.
You're not sitting there feeling miserable, you're sitting there playing with the blanket for the giant, colossal, humongous man.
Blanket for the baby.
This is not a blanket. This is an area rug.
Her goal is to keep going until she can cover all the floors throughout the house.
My goal is to keep our baby warm.
Yeah, all the way through his college years.
Yeah. Well, you two funny men keep laughing because the only people that will get to use this blanket when it gets cold are me, the baby, and anyone else in the world who isn't you two.
Well, luckily, that's how many people it's going to cover.
Oh, leave me alone. Go back to scaring innocent little kids and giving them nightmares in exchange for candy.
Come on, Jens, it's trick or treat.
Yeah, what makes you think those kids are so innocent?
Oh, come on, Andrew, they're like 6 years old. How uninnocent can they be?
Hey, we didn't have to be here. We could have gone to Travis and Allison's party.
I didn't want to go to any party the way I'm feeling, and I certainly didn't want to go as a pregnant nun.
I was going to be the guilty bishop.
Well, it's mostly couples, and I thought since Andy and I split up, it would be kind of awkward.
So sorry about that. I know how much you liked her.
Liked her? I was head over heels in love with her.
So what happened?
I'll tell you. You can't tell anyone. Especially Mom.
Okay.
Last month, Annie told me she was pregnant.
Whoa.
Andrew, that's great. That's not great. What happened?
What happened was, I was thrilled about it, and she wasn't. She said that she couldn't have a baby right now. That she couldn't be a doctor and still have a baby. I said that I'd take care of it. She'd go to school, and I would take care of it. We argued about it for about a week, and then one day, while I was at work, she got rid of the baby. I didn't know what she was doing until it was all over.
Andrew, I'm so sorry.
It all went downhill from there. She finally ended it a week ago. She said that we were drifting apart, that it wasn't me, it was her, that she needed her space. I think she used every line I ever heard from the How to Dump Your Loser handbook.
You are not a loser. She was lucky to have you.
I think it was over the second she told me what she did. I just don't see how she could do that, you know? It was a baby, a living thing. And it was as much mine as hers. It's just, it's not right. I mean, it was partly mine. How come what I want doesn't matter?
What you want does matter. At least it should. Personally, I don't see how anybody can get rid of their baby.
Hey, having a baby's a personal choice. And a huge decision. I mean, maybe it's better that somebody wait and have a baby they're going to mistreat.
We're not talking about deciding to have a baby. We're talking about a baby that's already been conceived. Once the baby is there, the decision is over as far as I'm concerned.
Well, everybody doesn't feel that way, I guess. I mean, but who knows what's the right or wrong answer? As far as I'm concerned, it's between the individual and God.
How can you think it's right for somebody to get rid of their baby?
I didn't say I did. Look, besides, I'm the guy. We don't get a say. Ask Andrew.
Hey, you two, stop it. Okay? I'll get over it. It'll just take some time. Besides, I came over here to spend time with the two people I know who are in love, who know what they want, and who have their act together. Besides, it's Halloween. Let's stop talking about my depressing life and start scaring the crap out of little kids!
Time.
and I don't have any gas in the car, so we need to go get some gas. Hold on. Right there, buddy. Here, we can have all this candy. Just watch my wife, okay? Make sure nothing happens. Just watch her, and everything will be okay. Here, he's right. Angel, come here! Oh,
Daddy! What's the matter with you people?
Tired of the false labor, that's all.
Well, I'm so sorry for all of you.
Look, it's been, what, like 15 false alarms so far? I mean, good God, if we get anything, we should name the kid Braxton Hicks McCain.
Excuse me!
Look, Jan and Kathy have been here more in the last month than I have. I mean, good God, they were here on Thanksgiving.
Oh, well, I guess I'm just an inconsiderate bitch. I didn't mean to ruin everybody's Thanksgiving.
All I'm saying is they left their family and their Thanksgiving meals to be here for a false alarm. That's all I'm saying. Nobody's blaming you for anything.
Yeah, well, I should hope not, because I'm the one who's been in misery for the last 9 months carrying this baby, and it's all your fault. You did this to me!
have a baby, not me. I wanted to be a writer, Jen. Do you remember that? Well, you see this pad of paper, there's nothing on it. You want to know why? Because I don't have time to write anymore. I don't have time to think. All because you decided you wanted to have a baby. And once you made that decision, it didn't matter what I wanted because you conveniently forgot to take your birth control pills. And I'm the guy, so I don't get a say. So don't you dare say that I did this to you. You did this to me.
You think I got pregnant on purpose?
I don't know. Did you?
You're such an ass. Leave me alone, you jerk.
I'm so out of here.
Where are you going?
Anywhere but here.
I knew you'd leave me. I knew it.
You've been saying that for the last 9 months, Jen. We care for what you wish for, sweetheart. You just might get it.
Billy, wait. Don't go.
Go, don't go. Can't you make up your mind about anything anymore? Why? Why shouldn't I go?
Because my water broke.
Wait, what? Wait.
I think it started a while ago, definitely when we were fighting.
Well, why didn't you say something?
I wasn't sure at first we were fighting.
Okay, okay, let's just get you to the bedroom. Come on. Like we practice. Okay. Just look at me. Look at me.
Walk slower.
Okay. Okay. Just
walk faster.
Okay. Just focus and breathe, okay? Just focus like we talked about.
My belly hurts.
I know.
Slow down.
What do you think about these false alarms? The bed's all ready to go. Focus like we practice in class, okay? Just breathe and focus.
I'm
gonna just fine, Jen. It's just I'm gonna go in the other room and I'm gonna call Jen and Kathy. You just breathe and focus when they come, okay? Jenny's water broke, and she's having contractions, so it's the real thing this time. So if you could just get here as soon as possible, that would be great. Thank you. Jenny, Okay, these contractions are coming awfully close together. I really think we need to go to the hospital, so I'm going to go get the car, okay?
Oh, Billy, wait, don't leave me.
Jenny, I'm worried.
Billy, please don't go. I want you to know I love you.
I love you too. Well, maybe I better check down there and see how dilated you are. Completely dilated.
Oh, here he comes again, Billy!
Oh, oh, oh. Jenny, you're bleeding. Jenny, I can see the head. I can see the head, and you're bleeding a lot. And your skin's ripped a little. Jenny, I don't know. Just hit me. I almost lost you, Jen. You and the baby. I almost lost you. I started thinking about my life. So lost.
Kline, you saved our lives. Both of us. You got the cord unwrapped from the baby's neck. You cut the cord and clamped it off. You got both of us to the car and both of us to the hospital, all in the nick of time. The doctors told me that another 5 minutes and I would have lost too much blood. They said that if you hadn't done everything that you did, just the way that you did it, we would have died. You saved our lives.
I don't even remember most of it. It's like I was outside my body watching somebody else do it all.
Well, I was kind of out of it towards the end too, but from what I remember, it sure looked like you. It's almost as if this was all meant to be. I mean, look at everything that happened. Jan's phone falls in the birthing tub and fries. Kathy Mack's battery dies in her phone, all right at that time. It's as if you were meant to bring your child into this world. You know, for so long I was so sure you weren't gonna be there for me. And in the end, you were the only one who was. I'll never doubt you again, Billy McCain.
You know, it's funny. I was so sure that having a child would keep me from doing things. Keep me from making my mark on this world. I was wrong. I'll never do anything bigger than her. She's my mark on this world.
If you ever decide to start writing again, maybe you could write down the story. Everything that happened.
That's a great idea. I'll write down everything that happened in the last 9 months. I'll write her story.
Oh, isn't that funny? I can't believe I missed that. I think I'm the first in my family to get it wrong. I was so sure she was a boy.
It's because she's so strong. Like her mother.
Well, at least I kept the tradition of passing down the name.
Little Emmy Teresa McCain. Thank you for that.
What else could I name her? Besides, she's the same birthday as your mom, and naming her after your guardian angel seems just right.
Your mother would be so proud.
I'm pretty sure she already is.
Look at her. Not like a light.
She's exhausted. She's been playing all day. Kicking and smiling and laughing. She'll probably sleep for a while. Look at her, Billy. She's beautiful.
Of course she is. She looks just like her mother.
Thank you. Yeah.